Hello students of class 6, welcome to the online tutorial classes for Vidya Bhavan High Secondary School, and this video is for the life science, and the chapter that I will continue today is the digestive system, and this video is part 9. In the previous video, I have already discussed and completed the parts of the process of the digestive system. Today I will discuss about the assimilation. So assimilation is a new term for you. So what is it? Let me define. Assimilation. So all the foods or nutrients that we are consuming are not used by the body immediately. So they are changed into various forms that can be stored until they are needed. Until they are needed. This procedure is called assimilation. So as I already told you, the foods that we are getting, that we are consuming, our body cannot absorb or cannot use all the foods in one time. The some foods are being stored in various organs like in our muscles in the form of the glycogen and many of the things like fats and also in our adipose tissue for the future use. When we our body can't get the food, this storage can be used up. So this formation or this procedure is called the assimilation of the food. So, glucose is converted into glycogen and stored in the liver. When required in the body, the liver converts glycogen to glucose. Next, excess of glucose can also convert it into fat and stored in the adipose tissue, as I just told you. The fatty acid either provide energy or are stored under the skin like fat. The fat that is stored under our skin in our adipose tissue, it is actually not only to make us healthy or not only to make us obese. It is also for the storage. The storage is for the future use. When our body cannot get the food properly, the storage can be used up. Amino acids are used for the synthesis of the protein, as the amino acid, the smaller units of the protein. Excess amino acids are converted into urea, which is removed from the blood, from blood by the kidney and in the form of urine. So excessive amount of the protein and the urea can be digested after the digestion process. This blood is purifying this part and then it goes out from our body by this urine. Okay, so this functions you will learn on the urine formation. Okay, so let me summarize the functions of various digestive enzymes. Okay, so I'm just raising this part and I'm telling you. Okay, I'm just raising this part. Okay, let me just raise it. Okay. Okay students, so let me sum up the enzymes that are happening or from the mouth to the small intestine. Okay, so the parts here after the name of the enzymes and then the functions. So the first is mouth. Here mouth, the salivary amylase is present. And what is the function of it? To changes the starch into maltose. Starch to maltose. Now in the stomach. Here pepsin and renin present. the pepsin function is to make proteins to the peptones, and the renin function is to form from casein to paracasein. Okay, so the next is on the liver. Here the bile and the pancreatic juice. In the liver, only the bile present is on the small intestine, before the small intestine, the stomach part. Okay, so here the bile present or the bile juice, which can emulsify fat. Okay, so next in the pancreas, directly going to the pancreas. Here, two types of things are present, like lipase, like trypsin, and it is the only smaller parts of it. You know, beside that, or many more enzymes are present. Okay, this is just basic idea of it. Like first, the lipase function is to produce from fat to glycerol and fatty acids. Okay. Now the trypsin function. What is the function of the trypsin? To change proteins to peptones and also the proteases. Then from the proteases, the smaller units of the polypeptides, and finally from the polypeptides, the amino acids produced. Okay, and then the next part, the small intestine. So I'm raising the upper part, otherwise you can't see the parts. I'm only raising this mouth. Okay, the final is the small intestine. Here absorption also happens and digestion also happens. Here many of the types of enzymes are present, like the lipolytic enzymes, the proteolytic enzymes, like amylolytic enzymes, everything is present. Here, erapsin, it changes the proteins and peptides into the amino acids. And the peptides to amino acids. So here, the half done by this pancreatic juices is taking the polypeptides. Here, these peptides are forming the amino acid, the smallest units. Okay, and next, the maltase. It changes maltose to glucose. Okay, next, the sucrase. Sucrase from sucrose to glucose and fructose. Also here the lactase present. Lactase forming the lactose or milk sugar to the glucose and the lactose. So it is the all summer up of like digestion, summer up, or the various functions of the digestive enzymes. In the next video, I will discuss about the indigestion. Till then, thank you.